Hi everyone, so I am back, and in today's video we're going to be talking about Sony, Spider-Man and X-Factor. So let's talk about Sony and Spider-Man first of all. Well, basically, we've got an article here from Variety, and it says Sony dates two Marvel movies for 2020. If I have to guess what these are going to be, I would imagine it's probably Venom 2 and Morbius, meaning the movie based on Michael Morbius, the vampire, the well-known Spider-Man villain. Well, I say he's well-known. He's not as well-known as the likes of Doc Ock and Green Goblin, but he's still pretty well-known. So, of course, the Silver and Black movie has been cancelled. That was going to be a Silver Sable and Black Cat team-up movie. But now, apparently, they're going ahead on a solo Black Cat movie, and that will probably come out in 2019, I'm hoping. If it doesn't, then I would imagine it would come out in either 2020 or 2021. I mean, having to wait longer than that would just be a piss take, to be honest. But I want them to do the character justice, and I want them to get the script totally right and all of that jargon. But to me, this Black Cat that was in Marvel's Spider-Man 2018 video game on the PS4, yeah, this incarnation of Black Cat is just not my Black Cat. Like, it's not just available on PS4, by the way. It's available on other consoles as well, like Xbox One, I think. I'm not definitely sure. So basically, when they make the Black Cat movie, she has to be wearing this or something similar to it. She cannot be wearing this or anything similar to that. Okay? Because I will not be happy if that happens. Yes, I'll still see the movie, but I won't be very happy about it. Obviously, they need exactly the right actress to play Felicia Hardy, the Black Cat. Like, her personality has to be perfect. Her looks have to be perfect. I won't accept, like, anything less than perfect for a role as important as this. Like, Felicity Jones was a perfect actress to play her in Amazing Spider-Man 2, but we never actually got to see her in the Black Cat costume. Look, this suit has SJW written all over it, whereas this one doesn't. Look, I'm a feminist, okay, but I think that SJWs go way too far, way too extreme. For those who don't know what SJWs are, they're basically social justice warriors. So, basically, to me, this suit is more empowering for women than this suit is. Because I have the policy, if you've got it, flaunt it. Like, if women have got beautiful bodies such as this, why would they not want to show them off? Like, if we take a look at this Lego video game, for example, Lego Marvel Superheroes, you can see that she's wearing the costume that is basically that one. She isn't wearing this one in the video game, is she? Not in the Lego video game, I mean. So why is it acceptable for her to wear this in a kids game, but it's not acceptable for her to wear this in an adult game? Because this game is more targeted at adults than the Lego game is. Or, well, teenagers, I guess. Even if we look back at the Spider-Man 2 video game, this is what she was wearing in that game. What worries me the most about it, you've got to remember, Sony are making the Black Cat movie, but they also made this Spider-Man video game. So, are they going to have the Black Cat in the exact same costume in the movie that she wore in this video game? Well, hopefully not. But we'll just have to wait and see. Anyway, let's move on to X Factor now, because that's another thing that's basically been pissing me off lately. So we have this one Dalton guy. He basically represents Obama. See this black guy in this pit down here? Dalton represents him. This is basically a mural that hangs on the main Bank of America. Literally, there's a pyramid behind this guy here. And if we play this, see the triangle representing the pyramid right there? Basically, we're not going too far into symbolism in this video. That's all I wanted to say, really, in terms of symbolism. But basically, how do I put this? People are boosting up this Dalton guy to be better than he actually is, and it's really pissing me off. Same with this Scarlet person. They're boosting her up massively, even though she's not even that good, in my opinion. Basically, this Danny Telly guy, he's really good, though. I want him to win the entire competition. I will actually play some of these in a minute, so you can have a comparison of what each one sounds like. Charlotte Lilly, I wanted her to win the entire competition, but they didn't even broadcast her six-chair challenge, which I thought was really stupid. Kezia Povey, she got kicked out at judges' houses. She was in the Sweet Sense band. She was really good. Like, I think I would have been happy if she won as well. Basically, Brandon on X Factor, I hate him because, number one, he's a crap singer, in my opinion. And number two, like, he has overreactions to get him through, like, every single week. Like, he literally throws himself to the ground and puts, like, his hands on his face, and it's just, like, over the top. Like, there's no need of it. And then, of course, we have YouTubers who are actually better than X Factor contestants, such as these people here, Molly and Hannah. So, what we're going to do now is we're going to play a bit of each of the artists I've mentioned so far, apart from Brendan, because I refuse to play him, because he gets on my bloody nerves. So tell me what you think in the comments, I guess.
Say sorry, I gave you stop me, but you still need her.
So, the point of me playing this at the end, it's basically because I would rather listen to this 100 times over than listen to Dalton, Brendan and Scarlett. That's just my opinion. But maybe other people agree with me, I don't know. If tell me in the comments if you want. But, yeah, so if you're interested in this YouTube peep, or Doctor Who peep, then check out this channel. It's called Doctor Who Poop. So subscribe for more